Hello everyone, welcome back. This is the fifth lecture on the topic Impact of Jet on Veins. In the previous lectures, we have discussed how to apply the impulse momentum principle to find the impact of jet on a stationary vein or a moving curved vein or on a series of curved vein mounted on a wheel and the corresponding work done and efficiency. So, in this lecture, we will discuss numerical examples showing the application of these concepts. Before we start the numerical examples, let us quickly glance through various concepts that we have discussed under this topic. We have discussed the impact of jet on a vein, particularly a curved vein which is symmetrical about the axis of the jet, and when the vein is stationary, we have seen the expression for the force along the direction of the jet, that is Fx equal to rho ab square into 1 plus cos theta. And since the vein being stationary in this case, work done is equal to 0, where rho is the mass density of the fluid forming the jet, A is the cross-sectional area of the jet, and V is the velocity of the jet. Also, theta is known as the vein angle, such that the incoming jet gets deflected through an angle 180 minus theta due to the impact. Next, we have seen if the vein is moving with the velocity u along the direction of the jet, the impact of jet is given by rho a into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta. The corresponding work done is given by fx into u, and the efficiency is given by this output power, that is work done per unit time divided by input kinetic energy, that is 2u into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta divided by vq. Next, we have moved on to the case when there are a series of curved vanes mounted on a wheel. And in that case, the impact of jet is given by fx is equal to rho a v into v minus u into 1 plus cos theta, and the corresponding work done is fx into u, and the efficiency is given by 2u into v minus u into 1 plus cos theta divided by v square. We have seen the condition for maximum efficiency, that is when the tangential velocity of the wheel u is equal to half of the jet velocity, that is v by 2. In this lecture, we will discuss three numerical problems. The first one is about the impact of jet on a stationary curved vein, and the second one, the jet impact on a moving curved vein, and the last one, impact of jet on a series of vanes mounted on a wheel. The first example is this. A jet of water of diameter 60 millimeters, moving with a velocity of 40 meters per second, strikes a curved fixed symmetrical plate at the center. Determine the force exerted by the jet of water in the direction of the jet. If the jet is deflected through an angle of 120 degrees at the outlet of the curve. So we need to understand what is the type of problem that is given and what are the information given in the question. First, we need to write those things, then we will select the appropriate equation, substitute the values and solve for the answer. So, this is the case of a symmetrical plate curved one, and the jet is striking the vein at its center. So, in this case, nothing is mentioned about the velocity of the vein. So, we can assume that the vein is stationary. That means the problem is that of a jet striking a curved vein at its center and the vein is stationary. Now let us see what are the data given in the question. Diameter of the jet is mentioned as 60 millimeters, and we use the diameter as small d, and that is given as 60 millimeters. And it is mentioned that the jet is moving with a velocity of 40 meters per second. The convention that we use for the jet velocity is capital V. So, capital V is 40 meters per second. And it is also mentioned that the jet is deflected through an angle of 120 degrees. This angle, the deflection angle here in this case is 120 degrees, which is 180 minus theta is equal to 120 degrees. So, these are the information given. Diameter of the jet d equal to 60 millimeters, velocity of the jet v is equal to 40 meters per second, and deflection angle is equal to 120 degrees. And in this case, we need to determine the force exerted by the jet of water in the direction of the jet. So the force exerted by the jet of water in the direction of the jet is what is represented as Fx. So the question is, determine the value of Fx. So we know that in case of a stationary vane, the force exerted by the jet along the x direction is given by Fx is equal to rho a v square into 1 plus cos theta, where rho is the mass density of the fluid. In this case, the stream is of water, therefore density is rho is the mass density of water. Though it is not given in the question, I hope all of you know the mass density of water, which you have studied in fluid mechanics, that is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Mass density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. A is the cross sectional area of the jet. So A can be determined as pi by 4 into d square, where d is the diameter of the jet. Diameter of the jet, d is given as, it's given here as 60 millimeters. So 60 millimeters, or when converted into meters, 60 divided by 1000, that is 0.06 meters. When you substitute for d, the cross sectional area of the jet A is given by pi by 4 into 0.06 square, which is equal to 2.827 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter square. Now you know the value of rho, you know the value of area, cross sectional area of the jet, and v is the velocity of the jet, which is already given to you. And you also need the value of theta. It is mentioned that deflection angle 180 minus theta is 120 degree. Therefore, the vane angle theta is equal to 180 minus 120, that is 60 degrees. Substitute all these values in this expression. So Fx is equal to 1000 into 2.827 into 10 to the power minus 3 into velocity is 40 square into 1 plus cos 60. So when you substitute all these values, Fx you can calculate as 6785.8 newton. So this is the force exerted by the jet on the vane along the direction of the jet. Moving on to the second example, this is the case of a moving vane. You can see here that a jet of water of diameter 60 millimeter strikes a curved vane at its center with a velocity of 18 meters per second. The curved vane is moving with a velocity of 6 meters per second in the direction of the jet, and the jet is deflected through an angle of 165 degrees. Assuming the vane to be smooth, calculate the thrust on the vane in the direction of the jet, power of the jet, and efficiency of the jet. So let us first list what are the data given. Diameter of the jet is given as 60 millimeters. Diameter of the jet is represented as D. Therefore, D in this case is given as 60 millimeters. And velocity of the jet is 18 meters per second. And the convention that we use for velocity of the jet is capital V. So V in this case is 18 meters per second, and the curved vane is moving with a velocity of 6 meters per second. This is the velocity of the vane, which is represented using U. So U is 6 meters per second, and it is mentioned that u is in the same direction as that of the jet, that is u and v are in the same direction. And the jet is deflected through an angle 165 degrees. So this is 180 minus theta, that is given as 165 degrees. So d, v, u and 180 minus theta are given to us, and d is 60 millimeter, v is 18 meters per second, u is 6 meters per second, and 180 minus theta is 165 degrees. What is it that we need to calculate? The thrust on the vane in the direction of the jet, that is along the x direction, what is the impact of jet, which is fx. This is what we need to determine in the first part. Power of the jet, that is work done per unit time, which is wx in this case, and the last part talks about the efficiency of the jet. So these are the information given to us, and these are the values that we need to calculate. Remember, this is a case of a jet of water striking a moving curved vane at its center, and velocity of the jet V and velocity of the vane U are in the same direction. For this case, if we check the equations for the impact of jet, work done and efficiency, we can see that the thrust on the vane along the direction of the jet Fx is equal to rho A into V minus U whole square into 1 plus cos theta. Work done is Fx into U, and efficiency is given by 2U into V minus U whole square into 1 plus cos theta divided by Vq. As we have done in the previous problem, so we know Fx, Wx and efficiency expression. So diameter of the jet is given to us, that is diameter of the jet is equal to 60 mm, which is equal to 60 divided by 1000, that is 0.06 meters. Therefore, we can calculate area of the jet. Area of the jet is represented as A, and that is given by pi by 4 into d square, that is pi divided by 4 into 0.06 square, which is equal to 2.827 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter square. And also we know that the mass density of water, since water is the jet is of water, mass density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Though it is not mentioned in the question, you should be knowing that mass density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Also, deflection angle in this case is given as 180 minus theta equal to 165 degree. Therefore, vane angle theta is equal to 180 minus 165, that is 15 degrees. That is the vane angle. Now, we know the area of the jet, we know the density of water, we know the value of theta, we know the velocity of the jet and velocity of vane. Substitute all these values in this expression, which gives us Fx, the thrust on the vane along the direction of the jet. Fx is equal to 1000 into 2.827 into 10 to the power minus 3, which is the area of the jet. Then V minus U, velocity of the jet V is equal to 18, velocity of the vane U is equal to 66. So V 18 minus 6 the whole square into 1 plus cos theta, where theta is the vane angle, which is 15 degrees in this case. So 1 plus cos 15. You can calculate this so that you will get the answer Fx is equal to 800.3 newton. That's the answer. That is the thrust exerted by the jet on the vane along the direction of the jet. That was the first part of the question. And in the second part of the question, we need to determine the work done. So work done, though this is the expression, it can also be written as, since we have calculated Fx, it can be written as Fx into U. which is now FX is 800.3 multiplied by U is 6. So you will get this as 4801.8 unit is Newton meter per second, or you can write it as, instead of Newton meter per second, you can write it as watt, because work done per unit time is the output power, or you can write it as 4.8 kilowatt, that is the output power produced by the jet. Let us also consider the third part of the question, what is the efficiency. This is the expression for efficiency, and if you substitute the values, 2 into U is 6 into 18 minus 6 the whole square into 1 plus cos theta, theta is 15, divided by V cube, V is 18, so 18 cube, which gives you answer 0.5825, or I can say that this is 58.25%, which is the efficiency of the jet in this case. That is how you can calculate the thrust on the way, work done by the jet on the way, and the efficiency. I hope all of you could get the answers correctly. Now let us move on to the third problem. Here, a jet of water of 100 millimeter diameter and having a velocity of 15 meters per second impinges at the center of a hemispherical vane. The linear velocity of the vane is 5 meters per second in the direction of the jet. In the first part of the question, you need to determine the force exerted on the vane in this case. And in the second part, you need to calculate how much this force would change if the jet impinges, instead of a single vane, if it impinges on a series of vanes attached to a circumference of a wheel. Again, as usual, let us start by identifying what is given in the question. So, it is mentioned that a jet of water of 100 millimeter diameter, that is diameter of the jet is 100 millimeter, that is D is equal to 100 millimeters, or 100 divided by 1000, that is equal to 0.1 meters, and is having a velocity of 15 meters per second, that is velocity of the jet is, that is V is 15 meters per second. Jet velocity V is equal to 15 meters per second. And this jet impinges at the center of a hemispherical vane. That is another important information. So, when the vane is hemispherical, the vane angle theta is equal to 0 degree. That is what I have written here. When the vane is hemispherical, we have seen in all the previous lectures that for hemispherical vane, the vane angle theta is equal to 0. Next, the linear velocity of the vane is 5 meters per second. Linear velocity of the vane is the velocity with which the vane is moving, that is represented using u. So, the vane velocity u equal to 5 meters per second. And it is also mentioned that u is in the direction of the jet, which means that u and v are in the same direction. Now, since the diameter of the jet is given to you as 100 millimeter or as 0.1 meter, you can calculate the area of the jet as pi by 4 into d square, that is pi by 4 into 0.1 the whole square, which will give you 7.854 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter square. And for the first part of the question, in case of a single moving vane, what is the force exerted by the jet on the vane? So, we know that in case of a single moving vane, the thrust or the force exerted by the jet on the vane along the direction of the jet is given by Fx is equal to rho a into b minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta. This is the case we are discussing about, a single vane that is moving along the direction of the jet, and jet is in pinching the wheel at its center. So for this case, force along the x direction is given by fx equal to rho a into p minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta. So let us substitute the values for rho a, b minus u, etc. So in this case, again the liquid that is flowing is water. So the density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube, and substituting all these values here, density is 1000 kilogram per meter cube, cross sectional area of the jet is 7.854 into 10 to the power minus 3 into b minus u. B is the jet velocity, that is 15, u is the velocity of the vane, that is 5. So 15 minus 5 whole square into 1 plus cos theta. Theta in this case is 0. So you can substitute the values and calculate the thrust as fx is equal to 1570,570.80 newton. That's the answer to the first part of the question. In the second part of the question, it's mentioned that if the single vane is replaced with a series of curved vanes mounted on a wheel, how the force is likely to change. That means now we need to calculate the force exerted by the jet on a series of curved vanes mounted on a wheel. And we have already seen the expression for that, that is fx is equal to this force along the direction of the jet. Fx is equal to rho av into v minus u into 1 plus cos theta, and all these values we have already determined. So mass density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube, cross sectional area of the jet is 7.854 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter square. B, velocity of the jet is 15 meters per second, it is given in the question, into v minus u, 15 minus velocity of the vane, that is u equal to 5 meters per second, into 1 plus cos 0, because theta is 0 in this case. And if you substitute all these values, you can calculate fx as 2356.2, that is 2356.2 newton. That's the answer to the second part. So when there was only a single vane, the force exerted was 1570.8 newton. When you replace that with a series of curved vanes mounted on a wheel for the same jet, you without changing the parameters of the jet, you can attain a force 2356.2 newton. That is the answer to the second part of the question. We will continue this discussion in the next lecture. Thank you.